basic things that you need. You're loved, you were taught about your purpose, about your identity. That means you grew up in a dysfunctional family.
Sure.
You might have had the bed of roses and video games, you know, in this day and age. But if you're not taught about your purpose, if you're not loved unconditionally, if you're not taught who you are, you grew up in a dysfunctional family.
But what you're actually telling me is that you will never then have peace. Because the Israelites, when they were moving around and around for 40 years, the mm-hmm. Lord said, I will not give you my peace.
Mm-hmm.
So something tells me when I'm not in God's way, I will not have peace.
Yes, because peace is the culture of God's kingdom. Because Paul said in Romans 14, kingdom of heaven, kingdom of God is not meat and drink, but righteousness, peace, and joy in the Holy Spirit.
Yes.
That is the culture of God's kingdom. So when we are not living in God's kingdom, we won't have peace. So anytime we feel troubled, because our mind, there's a thin line between living in God's kingdom or in living in the flesh or living in this according to this world system. That's what Jesus said in Matthew chapter 6. He kept on telling us, do not worry.
And we do. We worry all the time.
Do not worry about what you're going to eat.
Yeah.
But that's what most people are worried about. Do not worry what you're going to drink. How is possible, Jesus, in 21st century, living in South
2024,
Africa, 2024, United States or India or China, how can a person live without worrying? It is only possible when we truly discovered God's kingdom and live in it. Then he becomes the provider.
Mm.
He becomes the protector. Just like he provided for Adam. How did Adam live?
Mm.
What did he do to provide for himself? That was not his job. Bible says God came down and planted a garden.
Wow.
Why would God come down to plant a garden on the earth? Because God knew this Adam, my son, by the way, Adam was God's son. He needed a place to live, food to eat, because the Father already knew. That's what Jesus told, the same thing in Matthew 6. Your heavenly Father knows that you need all these things before you ask him.
Yeah.
Majority of our prayer request is asking God to provide, protect, and take care of us.
Mm.
And according to God's kingdom, those prayers are not valid.
Yeah, but while I'm listening to you, there must be a mind change.
Mind shift. That is called repentance.
Wow.
Repentance is not feeling bad for yourself. That is confess your sin. Repentance is totally different. People get confused about confessing your sins and repenting.
Yes. Yes.
Repentance
yes.
is changing the way we think.
Yes.
So when I migrated from India to the United States, guess what? I had to change the way I think.
Mm.
In the culture I grew up in, I was taught a certain way. I ate a certain kind of food. I spoke a certain language. But when I went to the United States, they don't speak the same language there. They don't eat the same food. They don't drive on the same side of the road. So I had to learn a new way of living.
Mm.
So when you're born again, you became part of God's kingdom, you have to learn a whole new way of living life. But that's not what we do. We just continue whatever culture we grew up in, whatever language, Africans, Indian, English, or group, we just continue and thinking that someday something is going to get better. It is a lie.
And your hope makes you depressed because you're not living a kingdom life.
Yes, because when we are not fulfilling what we were created to do, we will feel unfulfilled. We feel like we are lost. That's what most people are feeling. Because they are not doing what God created them to do. Why they were born on this earth for. That's why Jesus came and told us, seek first the kingdom. Whatever we seek without And I did a study on the word first in Greek, in Hebrew, in Latin, in every language on the earth. Do you know what I found?
Mm-mm.
What the word first means?
Mm-mm.
It means first.
I was waiting for this answer now.
In every language, it means first. That means whatever we do first, it won't work. Because it's the command of the king, our Jesus. He's the king of the kingdom.
Yeah.
He told us to do something first. And if we try to do anything else other than that,
it's not going to work.
It's not going to work.
How hungry are you for the real kingdom? I'm not talking about church. I'm not talking about religion. I'm talking about living in his kingdom. When you go to visit a friend, you have to do what they do. You have to eat what they eat because you're visiting them.
Mm-hmm.
So your Father in heaven has got his kingdom. We have to do what he is doing. We have to live like he is doing. And some people think, I've got it, but we don't have it.
Mm-hmm.
I think we're missing the boat.
Mm-hmm.
This book is absolutely for free for you.
When they take the course. If they take the course from the university, this book is free.
And the course is also for free.
Course is free.
This course is for free. And you can go to Abram John. Just give out
the
ministry.
Kingdom. Yeah, if you go to thekingdomuniversity.org and sign up for Discovering the Lost Kingdom course, and they can download this book and the study guide for free. But if they go to the website looking to buy it, they had to pay for it.
Mm.
If they just want to buy the book, there's a cost. But if they take the course, which is free, the book and the study guide is also free with that course.
You are so amazing. You're actually giving it for free to people because you want him. Your urge is so deeply from start knowing the God. Knowing Jesus.
Because you cannot put a price to God's kingdom.
Yes.
God's kingdom is like a treasure hidden in a field. A man found it, went back and sold all that he had, back and bought that field. I am one of those men. I had to get rid of everything I built up, everything I was, everything I used to transition into God's kingdom. And I am still learning. But for the most part, I live in God's kingdom, fulfilling what he created me to do.
Wow. I really want to encourage you to do this course, The Lost Kingdom, Discovering the Lost Kingdom. Are you there already? Remember, for the next 1,000 years, in the millennium, you're going to live kingdom for eternity.
Eternal.
Can you imagine?
Forever.
Just for a second. Can you imagine how long is eternity? They say when a bird comes and sharpens his beak against a mountain every 1,000 years, and that mountain goes down, 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 down. When the mountain is totally down, then eternity starts only. It's mind-boggling how long eternity is going to be. Isn't it worth to live in the kingdom? Abram, thank you very much. It was so amazing speaking to you.
You're welcome. Thank you.
I don't think people can still grasp with their minds how deep is this relationship, kingdom. Go and read Matthew, John, Luke.
Mark, Luke, and John.
And see what is the kingdom about.
Mm-hmm.
And ask the Holy Spirit. You cannot do this without the Holy Spirit. This is a different mindset. It's a spiritual mindset, right or not. You cannot comprehend this with your mind and your soul side. It must be with your spirit.
Yes. And also, that is the original mind God wanted us to have. But our mind got corrupted by sin and by the things we experienced in life. But now he wants us to have the new mind. That's where the renewing the mind means, or the mind of Christ. The Bible says we have the mind of Christ, not going to have.
And I sense that people are telling themselves, oh, I'm not good enough. I can't do that. Let me tell you one thing. Don't listen to that voice, because God will never talk to you like that. God will never say that. Holy Spirit will never speak to you like that. Because the Word says, Romans 8 verse 1, for those who are in Christ. What is the scripture further on?
There's no condemnation for those who are in Christ.
Condemnation. Yes. There are no condemnation for those who are in Christ. There's no condemnation. So stop listening what the devil is telling you, because eternity is awaiting you. And you know what? God wants you in His kingdom. He needs you in His kingdom. Mm-hmm. There's people that you're going to meet that your neighbor or he or mom and dad or your husband and wife is never going to meet. And God needs you to fulfill that purpose to get to the kingdom or to walk into the kingdom and to be there in eternity. One day you're going to see how many people was on your list that you had to pass and deal with and pray for.
Mm-hmm.
Isn't that true?
Amen. So once we experience the kingdom and live in it, it's our responsibility to share. But our purpose of evangelism all these years as trying to take people to heaven, that's not the purpose. That is after we die, we go to heaven.
Mm-hmm.
But there is a life to live on the earth. There's a purpose to be fulfilled, a call to answer.
Are you answering the call? Be part of this university. Enroll to this university.
Yes.
The Kingdom, the Lost Kingdom.
TheKingdomUniversity.org.
TheKingdomUniversity.org. You will see it on the screen. Abram, thank you very much.
Would you
just do a prayer for us before you go?
Father, in the name of Jesus, I ask all of these precious people who are watching from all across the globe, thank you, Holy Spirit, for giving the revelation of the kingdom of God. I release the seed of the kingdom of God into their spirit man right now, that they will see something they never saw. Thank you, Father, for opening their eyes to see the destiny, the plan that you have planned for them in eternity. We thank you. Thank you for this privilege. Thank you for this opportunity. And for the glory of Jesus Christ, we say amen.
Amen.
Amen.